Hey, welcome back to Valkyria Chronicles. It's moved to a new day. This will be Sundays from now on. So I'm going to finish up this chapter and move on to the next one. Let's see what's going on at the end of this one. People going to admit they're wrong?
The kid might got the chops to command, but that don't mean I gotta like any dark hairs.
That's a weird thing for her to be saying when you consider the fact that basically this is World War II, in which Japan was involved and on the wrong side of. This game is made by a Japanese group, and they're insulting dark hairs, which genetically, Japanese people generally have very, very dark hair. This is a weird, twisted thing to me, and I'm not really sure how I feels about it right now.
Sorry, this is about all I can do.
What? Video within one of these. Ah, there you go. You get to release those things out into the
maybe,
wind.
Once everybody returns, they'll see a couple of lion's paws blooming, and it'll start to feel like home again.
Plants do tend to grow in regional areas, and you've traveled quite a long distance from your hometown to this one. By doing that, you might have introduced an invasive species of plants into the area. I think that's pretty irresponsible, don't you?
Well, flowers, do your stuff.
Attack the local agriculture? That's what they're gonna do. Either that or the local agriculture will kill them. Very dog-eat-dog or plant-eat-plant in this kind of situation. Hey, awesome! We got a new sniper in. Cesare Regard. It seems like I'm kind of stuck on only having a certain number of people, and my army can't get very big. So I'm going to have to kick somebody out of my military. I think I'm going to kick out Kevin for right now, because he's a claustrophobe, and that's not really good for me.
My name is Cesare Regard. I'll handle things my own way, thank you.
A sniper who doesn't follow my rules. Well, considering I literally control where you move and what you shoot, you're gonna follow my fucking rules. I'm boosting this scout because I think with the scouts that I've got moving forward, they're gonna need better aim and everything else. Shock troopers, I really hope that they expand their running distance, that sort of thing. And snipers, I'm probably gonna level up as much as I fucking can. If I can just make them all amazing, then maybe I can win this war at a distance. Hey, nice. All right, I can get the new guns. Hopefully I can get them for fucking everything. That'd be nice. Okay, I can get one new gun. Oh, no, okay, sniper rifle. I can get one for that. Hopefully something besides just these two. The sniper rifle and the rifle upgraded. No new grenades. Ooh, new armor. Good. Upgraded the Edelweiss, upgraded my weapons and my armor as much as I could anyway, and I got a new sniper, so I'm pretty damn sure that's plenty for the background stuff. Thanks in part to Squad 7. You know, the way that you played out that last cutscene before, it's not in part. This was entirely due to Squad 7, according to the way they showed it.
The Cloden Wildwood. I was there last summer taking soil samples.
Congratulations. You now have a personal connection to that area, and a reason for you to take offense to the things that they're definitely doing wrong there, and a reason for me to care that you're taking offense. Notice all these cutscenes are pretty damn yellow. They got that mid-2000s to, actually, all through the 2000s kind of vibe to them, where games were basically just turning into gray and yellow. This one's got a lot of color outside of the cutscenes, but in the cutscenes they seem to have this vignette over them.
How shall we proceed? What says your grace?
Ah, your grace, huh?
We will extinguish these flames.
They made him blonde-haired and blue-eyed, so they're definitely making a comparison to the Nazis. But white hair and red eyes, brown hair and brown eyes, and blonde hair and blue eyes. So we know who the most evil is.
We're not alone here.
Yeah, but that was tall grass. Rustling of tall grass usually ain't soldiers.
I'll go investigate. Put your hands in the air.
That's kind of insane, ain't it?
Mink?
Oh, goddamn. Poor Cavian? And it says Moink. this is one of those games that's going to end up with some weird connotations, ain't it?
It's a pig?
It's a pig with wings.
It looks like a Porcavian piglet.
If a pig grows wings, that implies so many fucking evolutionary steps to mammals on this planet Earth that I don't understand why you need something like an unlimited energy source. That seems like it's the least of your fucking worries at this point. And it's a piglet, so why the fuck did you just pick it up?
Get separated from your mom?
You don't know that, because mom could be right around that fucking canyon.
I'll take a look further in.
Did the bad guys kill the pig's mom? Because that definitely gives Welkin motivation to fuck him up.
There must have been a skirmish here.
Yeah.
It looks like a stray bullet.
So the bad guys killed the mom, and that way we can blame them for hurting wildlife.
Even all the way out here, the war's still claiming lives.
Well, it would. Good guys and bad guys alike go hunting to make sure they've got supplies.
You lost your family too, huh, little guy?
That pig is gonna join my army.
Does he want to come with us?
He's gonna join my army.
What? Can we?
Well, I mean, you outrank most of the people there, and the lieutenant does get to choose his team, but if he kicks one of my snipers off the goddamn team for that fucking pig, I'm gonna kill Welkin.
We're the militia. Every Gallian has the right to join.
You hear that? As of today, you're a member of Squad 7, little guy.
Plus, all squads need a mascot. That's just a basic thing. You gotta have a mascot.
Moink? Moink!
The thing saying moink implies that it has lips. The M sound needs lips. That disturbs me. I don't know why it disturbs me, but you imagine a pig actually puckering its lips to use the letter M. I mean, it might tuck them back in to do it, but the K also implies a tongue that clicks in a certain way. That word requires a human fucking mouth. Oh, God. All right. So up here, I'm given two snipers. I'm putting Katie and Marina up here. Cesari's gonna have to go down with the other team because you're new. Sorry about that, Regard. You're gonna have to go and be with the new with the strong crew. Plus, they said the northern path goes around behind people, so I figured we need Jan up here because Jan has to go. There's really no option in that. And then Rosie's up here too. Rosie is gonna be leading this team. And the only reason I'm taking Rosie this time is because I want to make sure I've got all that CP, and I'm pretty sure she contributes to CP. And that goes the same down here. Alicia is coming, but she's the only scout coming with us. I need Alicia for the CP. I need Kobe, because Kobe is amazing and is coming with us. I need Largo for the CP, so he's down here. And then Cesari is down here as well. So that's the grouping of everybody. Here's hoping it actually makes fucking sense. They're also gonna come around this way. Oh, motherfucker! I did not look down. I didn't see the landmines. But I didn't think the landmines were gonna be up here. I thought the landmines were gonna be down south, and that was gonna be it. Well, shit. She is a bit fucked here. So I'm gonna take some ragnade. Goddamn chain link fence is protecting people from my sniper. If I don't get my tank going forward, it's gonna be a bit fucking stupid.
Anti-tank gunnery sighted on the north bank.
All right.
Pushing ahead could prove dangerous.
Well, I've already got my team over there moving up, so I guess we need to get rid of anti-tank on the north side, huh? Oh, that's an anti-tank cannon. All right, that ain't something that I was thinking about. Maybe we can hit it from here then. Can we hit the anti-tank cannon from here? We fucking can. One shot to kill. It's gone. The other team doesn't need to take it out in that case then. And he can't see anybody else over there. If you can't see anybody else over there, then that just means we're doing all right. Now, is that an anti-tank mine? I think it might be. You were trying to be sneaky motherfuckers with that shit. I like you having a personality. And I like you having a personality distinct enough that I can understand who you are. But if you can't shoot this guy from this distance in the head and fucking kill him, you are useless to me and you'll never be on the team again. Thank you. You've proven yourself worthy.
See what you get?
You can kill this guy, right? I mean, you've got plenty of shots to do it. Got him. That motherfucker's dead. Hey, and that was a CP scout. Well, then we're going to occupy this fucking camp. I don't think she can make it to that sandbag position without this guy shooting. So here's hoping she can kill him. He is like leaning his head forward. That should make it a lot easier to shoot him. Bob him back and forth. You better be good enough to hit him in the head then. Come on, Marina. You got some better accuracy with that better gun. Motherfucker. Oh, Marina. I need you to fucking duck. Here's hoping you don't fucking die. Come on, headshot. Got him. All right. Ooh, that's a little canyon right there. And he was a... Ooh, very nice. Anybody drops their CP down, that's good for me. It's a bit obvious that that's good for me, but... See, you can't shoot anybody else. Somebody else might come out of that little canyon there. I guess Rosie's about to run up that road up north. The North team is very important on this mission. At the very least, I am making them very important on this mission. Well, I ran into that damn tank mine, even though that was something I was specifically trying to avoid. Now, I can shoot the tank because it's going to do more damage to me than that Lancer. And I probably should, because I think Cesari's going to do more damage to that Lancer than he would the tank. I almost said she, just because I was getting used to snipers being women in this game. Well, I was hoping Cesari could just get a headshot and kill you, but you're crouched down. So I might be screwed on that front. You got a good shot. Cesari, you're proving very useful to me. But you might be kind of screwed on this next turn. You get 5 shots and it's 15 to kill the motherfucker. Okay, well then let's change to a grenade. Because a grenade will at the very least get rid of this fucking barrier. And that way he won't be crouching down behind it anymore. Did it hurt him? It knocked him back. It didn't hurt him at all though. And now you're just standing up here where you're definitely going to get shot. Damage minimal? That thing destroyed your treads. In one shot. How did you not? How?
Minor damage sustained.
Minor damage, yeah. Minor damage, my ass, motherfucker.
New target sighted. Ain't no stopping me.
What? Strong-willed. Oh, God. 4 shots to the head to kill. 19 shots to the body to kill. Please hit him with everything. Ooh, motherfucker's dead. You know, one of the main points of this shit was that I was gonna bring with me a goddamn engineer. I didn't fucking do that. At all. You are very fucking close. You better hit him with everything you can fucking hit him with. Okay, good. He's dead. I don't need another shot against the Edelweiss. And you've got plenty of run speed to get the fuck back. Oh, good. You actually did some fucking damage. You only got 1 shot left, so you're almost useless to me in this case, but at least you've got something there. Unfortunately, I need you to actually take that last shot, and you definitely need to hit this motherfucker. I really hope somebody decides they want to run over towards Rosie, and she just fucks him up. It'd be really nice if it was a captain.
Under minor fire.
Yeah, it's only minor fire, really, in this case. We need to take that forward base before they start putting reinforcements out there. And if you miss, god damn you, Welkin, if you miss.
Fire!
Good. All right. And that's one of their CP. Nice. Try to get past these anti-personnel mines. You got a grenade. I think that's what I'm going to use on this. You can put it right to him. Grenade at his feet. Almost dead. Motherfucker. I don't know why they have so many troops just kind of running around. And I definitely don't know why those two fuckers saw Rosie and then didn't come out to attack her. That seems like a real dumb move. She has another grenade. So I'm going to have her throw this other grenade and kill this motherfucker. And knock down a tree, but she's not a nature lover. Ooh, another CP gone for them. Lieutenant Nonikov. That's a guy with a name. Very nice. All right, well, at this point, I don't think we can shoot through the fences. They got people just fucking shuffling around their base and occasionally somehow running in sight lines of my people. I don't quite understand how I keep seeing their people. I'm pretty sure they're between buildings up there. That fucking hit him. Knocked him on his ass, which in turn knocked him to his feet. That makes him a fucking easy target. Now he better be an easy mark. Don't fucking miss the guy at that close. You're a sniper. Take a grenade. I don't want to bother trying to shoot you to death. It's just too much damn work. They lose a CP and Alicia is going to take over this base for us, so we got another fucking command post. Cesari doesn't have a long run here, but I'm definitely going to try if you can do this. Ooh, that would be a good shot, wouldn't it? All right, that would be a miracle shot right there. Cesari, you do this, I'm giving you a nickname. If you can't do it, then you stick with being Cesari. Ooh, damn! Oh, shit, I got to give you a fucking nickname. I wonder if an explosion might do something to you. It didn't do any damage, did it? No, you did. You didn't do any damage, but he got hit enough that he actually had to turn around and look at you. That's pretty fucking funny, actually. I think I can get Rosie to kill Nonikov? I almost called it Novikov. That's wrong. I was thinking Novichok. That fucking isotope they use over in Russia. Did that do fucking nothing? And he gets to shoot you to death. Or almost to death. Alright, I really need... Okay, no, he killed you. Motherfucker. You better be resting. You're not getting out of this fucking fight like that. She's a fucking MVP because she's running real fucking far. But that does mean that I can deploy one of my engineers. It's going to be Homer. Homer's depressing. But hopefully he'll get a little bit happier if I actually give him something to do. Are you kidding me? Nonikov is running back to his original place. You cunt nugget. I guess that should be said of all the Nazis, but especially a lieutenant who decided not to get into a fight with somebody. I need Homer, because I think Homer can do tank repairs.
Thank you.
Whoa! That is a lot more potential than I thought you had, Homer. Hell, that's a lot. You fully fucking repaired him. Or almost. This dude is pretty far off. Caesar, you can do this, right? I mean, it's kind of a look of the draw thing at times, but Caesar, you're the best. Did you hit the fucking rock right next to you? I get the feeling you hit a rock that was sitting right next to you. All right, Rosie. While nobody's looking.
I got here as soon as I
could.
Ah,
shit.
Apparently not soon enough.
I get into the base and a general shows up. That's some bullshit. This guy is definitely getting hit with a grenade this time. I may not have been able to get him before, but I'll get him this time. Didn't kill him. I think that making him stand up is probably a good enough advantage. They didn't gain any CP from that. I think you have to start with it. Oh, shit. I thought Caesar was over behind a tree. You motherfucker.
Welcome.
This is your what? If you say fault, you cocksucker. Oh, damn. Are you just gonna target people individually with your fucking tank? I think that makes you a cunt. Aw, goddammit. That thing doesn't look like it's got machine guns on it. That might have been a real dumb thing to say right before I die. Rosie is getting the rest of this fucking turn. She's standing right there in the middle of several fucking people.
Enemy sighted.
Here I come. Take a grenade, guys. Aw, motherfucker. Well, I got one of them. He just didn't die. Rosie is definitely the MVP at the moment. She's killed off almost everybody who's been killed off. But I really don't think that I can do much more of that at the moment. At least killed one of them. Oh! She almost got the second one. He gets a counterattack. She's gonna get a little bit of movement on this next one. Very, very little. But if I can get her to take that and kill this guy... Please kill this guy. Got him. Nobody else is standing at this base, which means I might be able to take the fucking thing. Can you get up to that flag? Good. I think occupying the enemy camp, we win. Fucking right, man. That ain't how I was planning it, but it worked. Well, that worked out a lot better than I thought it would, and Rosie ended up being a lot better than I thought I was gonna make her. So, I'm very glad at that. I guess I ought to upgrade my shock troopers again and make sure they stay on par with the snipers. Hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you come back for the next episode. We'll finish up this chapter and move on to the next one. I'll see y'all guys later. Bye.